Hey guys, how's it all going? Thanks for joining me. Thanks for tuning in to Brett's Fishing Diaries. I'm hoping tonight is going to be the night. Cod night. Please. Cod night. I am venturing out of Gorleston. I know. Gasp. Shock. Horror. But, lovely old boy called Stephen Woodhouse. Kind of a local legend, really. Been fishing Gorleston, Yarmouth, Lowestoft for over half a century. And he brings in the cod. And he messaged me and said, Brett, do you want to come with me to Lowestoft? There's cod showing. I went, hell yeah. So I'm just packing up the stuff. What is today, 27th? 27th October, Friday. And he's going to be picking me up in about 3/4 of an hour. It's now 2:30 in the afternoon. So I'm just getting last few preparations sorted out so I don't forget nothing. Sat there last night making up about 8 to 10 pulley panels. Got the torches, got everything. We're all good. And we're off to Lowestoft. And please give me my first cod. So next time you see me, we will be at Lowestoft. I'll show you around. I did go to this place before with Dwayne, and we checked it out, and it's just these massive boulders, and it just looked like Snag Sea to me. So we left. But Stephen assures me there's a couple of spots where you can fish there, and that's where we're going. So wish me luck, and yeah. Let's get fishing. Tomorrow, Saturday, 28th, is our 5th tight lines, calm lines meet up on Gorleston Pier. So I'm going to be knackered tomorrow. Time I get home tonight is going to be, well, I think we're fishing till at least 11. So it's going to be 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning, time I get home. And then I'm up again in a few hours to go with the pier. Anyway, I'll stop the waffle for now, and let's get to Lowestoft, see if we can't catch us a cod.
All right, we have arrived, and we are at, well, it's not quite sunny, but it's Lowestoft. There's old Woody. Bless him getting his gear. Let me show you a boat. So, we are right here. That's where I'm going to be pulling my bait through, or hopefully a cod. Load of boulders up there, which is, I think, where me and Dwayne looked last time, and why we said that was just too treacherous. You got bird's eye right here, if you want to know exactly where we are. So I'm here. There's another little gap over there, which is going to be Stephen. What's that, your Zimmer frame? Huh? Is that your Zimmer frame?
Yeah.
He's got all the gear, look. So, we just got here. It is low tide. It's, must be 3:30, something like that. There's a little tiny boat out there. It's pretty calm. It's certainly not cold. I've brought all my thermals, but I'm standing here in just my jumper. But we'll see how the night go. I'm filming with my camera, because that film's better at night. My camcorder's no good for dim light. So I'll get set up, and I'll bring you back. Check this out, look. This is what Stephen's an old school guy. He makes everything himself, look. He made this bar up to go on this wall, especially for this wall, for his umbrella. You can't beat it. Ingenuity. Yeah, we've actually come down a bit further because there's a bigger gap here so we can fish next to each other. And then Stephen's going to show me where the cod are. We're both feeling really confident. Cod on. Going to be using, I've got two Ronnies, obviously. Two hook flapper on one and a pulley panel on the other. and we're not going to go out far at all. 50, 60 yards, and that'll be us. Let's get going. Here's the panel rig I made up, guys. Just simple pulley panel rig, really. Couple of beads up the top to stop the pulley panel sort of messing with the main line. And then clip down clip, if you like. I like them, simple. All right, first rod, two hook flapper. It's one of those little tiny fishies on it. And the other one got some mussels on it. Then on the pulley panel, I'll probably mix up a bit of mackerel and something else. But let's get this out. Now, and I've done completely opposite what you said. Look where mine are. They're just to the right of all them bloody rocks. Look. Yeah.
And then you'd have to just.
I'll have to.
You know, if not, just move it there.
Shift up a bit.
Yeah.
It was just my casting. They just both went out that way.
No, the tide is now going.
Yeah.
Coming in and that will pull you round. But when you pull it in, stay in there and then come across there.
All right, mate.
All right. You'll get
the angle. Say hello to YouTube, Woody.
Hello, how are you getting on?
How's it all going?
This is the Noi.
Yeah.
This is the cod.
That is. Yeah, we're on for a cod, aren't we, Woody?
That's right.
Still pleasant, isn't it? It's not. It's got a bit cooler, but.
Yeah. But otherwise, it's okay.
Yeah. I think the thermals will be on in about half an hour.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll walk and get my hat in.
Yeah.
I will be wearing the other hat.
Your other hat, right, good.
The regular hat. I go through every so many
days. Yeah.
They don't last. They stretch. You know, I hate it when they get really big.
My sister knits mine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, my neighbour, she knitted them, balaclavas and all that.
Yeah.
But after a little while, I just can't put up with them. I like when they really pull round.
Yeah.
Round your head.
Yeah, this stretch. I have to double roll it up now so it sits
right.
Up to
my room. I did get the wife to put elastic band on.
Right.
And that's the amazing.
But no bites yet. What are them little fish that are in there?
Whitebait.
They're whitebait, they are,
yeah.
Whitebait, are they?
Yeah.
Well, I got a white on the 2 hook flapper, I got one of them. And a couple of mussels, obviously
I'd like to take
them on.
We'll use them baits up, see what we get.
Yeah.
And then once they start getting dark, then the cod come out to play.
I stuck a couple of razor clams on the panel.
Did you?
Yeah, just to see.
Yeah.
They're quite soft then, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah. Do you use much bait elastic?
Yeah, I used it on all of it.
Yeah, that's
yeah. What you got? What you started with?
Whitebait and squid and squid and bait.
Yeah.
And I put the worms on. I think we couldn't get any more worms.
Yeah.
I couldn't get any worms out of the other day. And we couldn't do that any worms. So we couldn't
half a time.
Yeah. If a card are out there, then leave.
They are, absolutely. They're out there tonight, Woody. They have That's to it. Be.
Well, Alfie's, he didn't fish the other day up there. Him and his mates had two or three things.
Did they?
Yeah. And they got them on the street.
Did they?
Yeah.
Is this the first time you ain't done the pier on a Friday for a while then?
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I thought coming, because that's this week when the tide is in.
Right.
Well, come out next week. Back
on the pier, yeah.
Monday I was at Boston,
yeah. Yeah, on the beach, yeah. Just waiting till you have.
Yeah.
Alright, we are on for cod. I ended up putting on the panel. excuse me. a couple of razor clams and one of those little fish. Just wrap that up for now, put that on there. I'm going to cut up some of this mackerel in a minute and some squid. Get a rig ready for the panel. Both casts were pathetic. The gap is here. My rods are there. So when I reel in, I'm going to have to reel in the left-hand Ronnie first and try and guide it through the gap. Tide's coming in pretty quick. Those rocks are going to be covered soon. Yeah, so I'll have to reel that one in first, bring it over, and then do the same with the other one and cast out a bit further to the left, which I thought I was doing, in fairness. They just, both of them flung out exactly the same way. But never mind, we're out there. We're in with a chance. It must be about half past, between 4 and 4:30, I ain't looked. Apparently, Woody says, don't put the worm on till it goes dark. So about 6 o'clock, I'll be swapping the flapper from bait to worm. It's a lovely afternoon. But it's supposed to rain a little bit later, but no heavy downpours or anything. Yeah. So I'm not going to go into a major waffle right now, because I'm in cod mode. Full on mission. This is my best chance tonight. Fish have been, you know, cod have been caught out of here recently. You can't get any better experience than young Stephen. He's like my Mr. Miyagi. I'm like the Karate Kid. Catch cod, let's get some. But no, you can't be experienced, can you? And I'll get every bait imaginable here. I've never had this much bait, which Stephen sorted out for me. Bless him, very grateful. Got a load of birds flying over in a V. I was just looking to see what they were. I think they're geese. They are, they're geese. I wonder where they've just come from. Going the wrong way, the warmer weather's over there. But yeah, I'm going to watch this for a little while. And I'll probably switch it back on when I go to recast them in a better spot. Stephen said we only need to go out about 50, 60 yards tops. Any further than that, you're going to start losing gear. So the tide's going to come right in soon. I'll come right up to this wall. So yeah, I'll bring you back soon. See you later. Yeah, he did come for a chat.
Oh, Alfie?
Yeah.
They said when he was telling me, because that night he caught that ray, didn't he?
That's
and
right.
He was telling it up beside me on the wall there. And
He said he used to take them on for his missus.
Oh, that's good.
That's
good.
But the one who's about 90?
Yeah, that's the one who you caught the
name. Okay, what's his name then? I can't tell him. No good at asking me.
That'll come to me.
Yeah.
We'll see if there's any crap.
Yeah, I'm going to reel mine in a sec.
Yeah. One keep the ball that way since it's ready for your car.
Most important. Oh, it's really different. But he gets nagged. Are you in the right spot?
No, ain't really been touched. Pulley panel, as that could have just been the way I bound it up. That's pretty much gone. So I'm gonna put a bit of mackerel on the panel. I'll tidy up these baits, put a bit more on the flapper, and get them back out.
That's better.
Right where I want them.
In Codland.
It's going to be a lovely evening. If that rain holds off, that's going to be lush.
Keep an eye on these.
Wait for that bounce.
I'm not going to say I've got a good feeling, but I am optimistic.
Who are these stupid flies about? No, they're doing me heading.
Bring you back in a minute.
Oh.
Well, positive couple of bites there, guys, but looks like I should have left it a bit longer. So I think I'll do that. That was on a 2-hook flapper, which I'll put bits of mackerel on. So I've done the same again. Put it out to the same spot. Should we get another bite? the sock on. How gorgeous is that sky? That's just gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous, coming towards the end of the late afternoon. Oh yeah, old Woody. I've just had bites on both damn rods and there's nothing on the end, so we think it's just small white and having a go. So I'll get baited up, cast back out. I've just had to move down a bit further, closer to Woody. Because where I was, for some reason, every time a wave came in, there must be some weird structure down the bottom. And threw up this massive wave. My bag and everything got drenched, and I was just baiting up, and that just missed me. But I very nearly got a soaking then. So, what have we done? Yeah, I've re-put out there. Just squid. Just mackerel at the minute. I'm gonna mount up a couple of panel rigs. Probably squid and mackerel. On a 2-hook flat where I put a couple of those little white baits. Yeah, at the minute we're both getting bites, but nothing's really grabbing hold. So I'm just gonna have a bite of a sandwich and I'll come back. Did it? Thought you had something then?
Yeah, we did. We got about halfway in, that fell off.
Ah. Well, we're starting to lose the light now, guys. Big old moon up there tonight, look. But nothing as yet. Little bite still. Won't be long, we'll probably swap onto the old worms. That's a nice picture, that might be a thumbnail. I'm going to reel these in soon, check the bait. So I'll bring you back in a bit. Well, in a blink, guys. Tiny little potent. Well, I've just cast out the 2-hook flapper with that little pout I got, and I got a bite on the pulley panel.
Heavy.
That wasn't a bad sized fish, but that was a dogfish. That came off just as I was about to get it over the wall. I thought I was in for a cod there. My whole heart was pumping. But never mind. It's a pouting and the dogfish I didn't get. But I've recast, the bait was fine. I'll leave it out a bit longer. I'll make up another one ready. Yeah.
Tiniest little flat fish ever.
There you go, guys. Tiny little flat fish. I think I got something on the other rod. Dogfish for Woody. Woody's had three dogfish. This probably could be number four. No, nothing. I'm assuming you can see me. The light's right in my eyes. Bites have slowed up now. For me anyway. Could mean they're stripped. I did have a bite on the two-hook flapper, which has got worm on. So they're probably stripped. I'll pull that in a second. No more bites on the pulley panel. I'll check that in a bit. but yeah, a bit uneventful. It's now just gone 7 o'clock. High tide is about 9:15. So we've got a couple of hours yet to high, and then we'll fish a couple of hours over. So my coffee's just about cold, so I need a drink of that before it goes stone cold. Not much waffling on this one, guys, because I can't even see what I'm doing. Bloody hell, that come over. But there'll be plenty of waffle on the next video, because tomorrow is the big meetup on the pier. And I got this new bait I want to show you. They look like dog turds, but we're going to try them. They're new boilies I'm trying. And with a secret ingredient. I'll talk about that in the next video, which will be tomorrow. Well, be filmed tomorrow. For now, I'm going to reel these in, check the baits, and hopefully cod are on the way. Let's get checking. What are you chuckling at yourself about? I don't know if you can see. A squid and mackerel. Woody's just caught a lovely pouting. Look at that. That's a good chunk, isn't it?
Yeah.
I ain't seen a pouting that big before.
Oh, that's a lovely one. That
isn't
was.
It? Cool. Nearly passed as a cod.
It is. Just didn't have any.
There you go, guys. Another little pouting. No cod, though. Well, Woody's had 5 dogfish now. 2 of them weren't even hooked. They just sort of wrapped themselves around the line and hung themselves. I got a little knock on the left-hand rod, but I'm gonna wait. Don't think I can ignore it anymore. Keep bouncing, left-hand rod. Another teeny. right, guys. Dogfish. I actually caught it this time. Grab a good bite. I'll make sure you can see. There you go. It's getting back.
All right, let's check this pulley panel.
Waiting.
Oh, yeah. That's on the pulley panel.
Was it?
Yeah.
Good. When they're there, as long as they don't come up in force, yeah, the card normally about.
There you go, guys.
We've got stacks of waiting. We got one or two cards.
Two centimetres, that. Did you see that? There you go.
At least you're in them now, isn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, that little extra, you get a bit better fish now, isn't it?
Yeah, they're getting bigger. Getting bounces off that left hand rod, which is the 2-hook flapper. I've actually got two big baits on there. Got a whole mackerel head on one and a whole squid on the other. But bounces again, I'll go for it. small whiting guys. That was actually the pulley panel. I got mixed up. Greedy bugger. Lost count now. What is that? Two whiting, two small pouting, two dogfish, but I lost one. Not a bad session so far. Don't know what time it is. Well, we're fairly certain, guys, I just lost my first cod. I was then about to get up to press record because I saw a little tap. And just as I stood up, the rod bent right down and the butt end came up. I hadn't set the drag. And I literally had to rush forward and grab it before it got pulled in. But as I got hold of it, struck into it, there was nothing there. So something got hold of it and pulled it really hard and then let go. I'm gutted. My heart was pounding. I was screaming like a girl. That whatever it was big. Had to be a cod. Had to be. Wow. I bet the old Ron Tom didn't know what was going on there. Right, that's now about 8:45. High tide's in about half an hour. So we'll keep going. See if we can get another one. I've set the drag this time. Can't believe that. Was that my chance? Now lost? Well, let's stay positive. We're gonna catch another one. Let's go. Left hand rod pulley panel's going again. waiting. No cod yet. There, guys, picked it up, it snapped straight away. That's on that.
Do you have to take that off a spool?
Braided line.
Huh? Do you take it off a spool?
What?
Leader. Where you got more men going?
No, I just take it off.
Do you?
Here you go, guys, another juicy whiting. Still no cod. Lost count how many fish I've had now. Another whiting. I've lost count now, I'm not even counting. I just want a cod. Well, I thought that was it. Big old whiting. I thought that was my first cod. Chunky thing. Might be a PB there. I hate eels. Right, I'm actually going to pack that rod away, guys. I'm just going to fish with the one rod. And I think we've got half an hour to an hour left. Yeah. All right, guys, that's the end of the night. I thought it was about 10 o'clock, quarter past 10. No, it's gone 11. I need to get back home. So does Woody. So we're now going to start packing up. Well, what can I say? Great session. I don't know. How many fish did I get? Let me know in the comments. How many fish? Plenty of whiting, some of them some really good size. Poxy eel at the end. Couple of pouting, couple of dogfish. And I'm pretty sure that might have been a cod that I lost earlier. I wish I'd have been filming so you could have seen the rod go over. If I hadn't been right next to it, I'd have lost that rod, I'd have gone in. But absolutely great session with awesome company here with Mr. Woodhouse. Thank you very much, Woody.
That's all right.
What can I say? certainly can't moan at the amount of fish I caught. How many did you have in the end, Woody?
I had eight dogfish.
Yeah.
One pouting and seven buoyants.
There you go. Plenty of fish out here at Lowestoft. Unfortunately, no cod, but my day will come. Thanks for watching, guys. Tight lines, calm minds, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.